Good morning, guys. We are now on our quarter 2, week 3 of our online distance learning, and we are going to talk about relation and function. So we will have the walkthrough of our self-learning module given by our regional office, the Pivot Collaboration, to tackle about this. Okay, so here is our relation and function lessons, and take note that it composed of 2 weeks, week 3 and week 4. So medyo mahaba-haba po itong nating tatalakayin, at binigyan po tayo ng 2 linggo upang pag-aralan ang lesson na to. Okay, so the standard form of the equation of the line is ax plus by equals c. And we all know about this one. So, tinatalakay na natin sa ating mga nagdaang lesson. And to graph the line, you need to find ordered pairs, which is x and y, that will satisfy the given equation. Hence, there is a relation that exists between these two elements, that one may be dependent to the other. The first element x of the ordered pair is called the abscissa, okay? And the second element y is called the ordinate. The set of abscissa is the domain, and the set of ordinate is the range. Take note of that, ha? Kapag domain, ito yung abscissa. And what is abscissa? Ito yung x. And then, if we have range, ito yung ordinate. And what is ordinate? Ito yung y. Okay? Thus, a relation is a set of ordered pairs. Relation daw is a set of ordered pairs. And a relation between the domain and range can be presented in different ways. Number one is yung tinatawag nating arrow diagram. Through arrow diagram, you can easily determine if it is illustrates a relation or function. Okay? For example, the domain correspondence range. So, the name of the teachers, ito yun, si Mr. Cruz, si Ms. Santos, si Ms. De Los Reyes, and si Mr. Sape. Then, month that a person is born, birth of month is January, May, and June. So, as you can see, si Ms. De Los Reyes at si Mr. Cruz ay May. Then, si Ms. Santos ay January, and si Mr. Sape is June. There are 2 elements in the domain that corresponds to only 1 element in the range. Okay? The correspondence is many to 1, and this is a function. Correspondence daw ay many to 1 kasi si Mr. Cruz at saka si Ms. De Los Reyes ay parehong birthday nila ay May. So many to 1. Okay? And this is function. Take note of that, ha? Kapag many to one, that is a function. Function po siya. Okay? Function. Okay. Ha? Siya ay function. Now, kapag po ang ating domain, our name of students, ito yung given, Jane, Joy, and James. Then, student's age, ito yung 15, 16, and 17. So, as you can see, every element in the domain is paired to only one element in the range. The correspondence is 1 to 1, and this is a function also. Kapag 1 to 1, siya ay function. Take note of that, ha? Function po siya. Ang ating ano ay 1-to-1 correspondence. Okay, function pa rin. And then, another, We have the name of head of the family, si JP, si Nathan, si Job, at si Romir. And then, ito naman yung profession nila, teacher and engineer. Si JP at si Nathan ay teacher. Si Job at si Romir ay engineer. So, more than one element in the domain, ito yun, is paired to only one element in the range. So, the correspondence is many to one. Kapag daw many to one, siya ay relation. Take note of that, ha? Many to one is relation. Okay? So, yun. Okay, now, the other thing is ordered pairs. So, ordered pairs is the set, this is a set of X and Y pair, which is X is always the first element or the domain, and Y is the second element or range. Okay, so for example, let the domain be set of numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Make set of ordered pairs that a range is twice the domain. Then C, range is greater than the domain. And B, range is more than the domain. Okay. So as you can see, we have ang ating domain ay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 2, 4, 3, 6, then 4, 8, 5, 10. Bakit ganyan? Kasi range is twice the domain, twice daw. So 1, 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 3 times 3, 3 times 2 is 6, 4 times 2 is 8, then 5 times 2 is 10. Twice daw kasi ano, yun yung set A. Sets A and B are both function. The correspondence is 1 to 1. Ito daw, yung set A and set B. The correspondence, while set C is a relation. Relation, the correspondence is many to many. Okay, so as you can see, kasi dati sabi dito, range is 1 more than the domain. So 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 plus 1 is 5, 5 plus 1 is 6. Okay, so as you can see, 1 to 1 lang yon. While set C, range is greater than the domain. The range daw is greater than the domain. So, as you can see, 1, 2, so mas mataas nga sa domain. We have 1, 3, 2, 3, 2, 7, then 5, 6. So, 1, 2, or many to many pa yun. Kasi the range is the dependent variable. Its values depends upon the value of the domain. Okay? Same po. And then, another thing to determine the relation and function, you can use the tables and the equations. The relationship between the domain and range can be illustrated using the table of values or equation. So for example, construct the table of values that will illustrate the cost of number of notebooks if the price is 12 pesos. Let X be the number of notebooks and Y the cost of the notebooks. So ito yung number of notebooks. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then X. Sabi dito, 12 daw yung amount ng isang notebook. So isang notebook, we have 12 pesos. Dalawang notebook, we have 24 pesos. And 3 na notebook, tatlong notebook, times 12, and that is 36. 4 times 12, 48. So therefore, X, ito yung X, is equal to 12X. So meron na tayong equation. X is equal to 12X or Y is equal to 12X. Okay, kasi function na siya. So, this is the value, magiging value ng y, f of x, ano, tinatawag natin. So, that is 12x. Yun yung po yung ating equations. Okay? Okay? So the total cost is dependent to the number of notebooks. And the dependent variable is y. Dependent variable is y. Pag sinabi kasi nating dependent, ito ay nakadepende doon sa value ng x. Independent po yung variable natin na x. Anong pagkakaibayan ng independent? Ito po ay malaya, kaya nga po independent. So ito dependent, ibig sabihin nakadepende lang siya doon sa value ng x. So you can get the total cost of the notebook y if you supply the number of notebook, which is x. Okay, so yun po siya. So diba, napakadali lang if we determine the relation and the function. Sabi nga nila, lahat ng function ay relation, pero hindi lahat ng relation ay function. Hindi doon nagpa-function. Okay? Now, another thing is by graphing. So, functions or relations can be illustrated through graphs. Madali lang po yun, control graphs. You can graph by plotting the points on the rectangular coordinate plane. You can take the points from the set of ordered pairs, tables of values, or equation, or vice versa. Okay, so for example, let us graph the ordered pairs in set A. So ito po yung ating values ng x and y, or the domain and range. And the equation is y is equal to 2x. Kaya as you can see, tumataas siya, ang rise niya ay 2. Yun yung kanyang slope of a line, diba? 2 over 1. So therefore, so yun po yung ating equation. Ano, ito yung ating graph of the equation na y is equal to 2x. At kapag naman po sinabi nating by graphing, dito po ginagamit na natin yung vertical line test. Kapag po dun sa vertical line test, isa lang po yung na-touch dun sa line, ibig sabihin siya po ay function. So kapag ang ating graph ay horizontal line, di ba ganitong horizontal line yung itong x-axis, kapag ganyan yung ating graph, ibig sabihin function po siya. Pero kapag siya ay vertical line, kagaya po nitong y-axis, siya po ay relation. That is not a function. Kapag ang graph po natin pabilog, siya po ay not a function also. Pero kapag ang graph natin ay, let's say, parabola, yan, going open downward or open upward, siya po ay pwedeng maging function. Pero kapag siya ay open left or open to the right, siya po ay not a function. Okay? So, yun lang po. Now, so for our learning task 1, identify the domain and the range, the domain and the range, and determine if it is a function or a relation. So, as you can see, lalagay lang po natin domain, yung value ng x. Then sa range naman, value ng y. Yan po. Parang hihimayin natin. Okay? And to determine if it is a relation or function, sabi nga natin, we can determine by graphing, balikan natin, by graphing, by tables and equations, by ordered pairs, and by arrow diagram. Sabi natin, a relation between the domain and range can be presented in different ways. So, yun na po yung mga different ways. Okay? Kapag naman po sinabi nating many to one, this is a function, then 1 to 1 is also a function, and this is 1 to many class, 1 to many, and this is not, that is relation. Okay. Relation po. Kapag ang value ng y ay marami, ibig sabihin kapag value ng y po ang marami, siya po ay nata a function. Ibig sabihin matatouch siya sa vertical line test by 2 or more points. Kaya dapat hindi maulit ng 2 beses ang value ng y. Take note of that ha. Hindi dapat maulit ng 2 beses ang value ng y. Kaya po siya ay relation. At hindi magiging function ang relation na yun. Parang relationship, bawal magdoble. Na? So, given the set of domain D, so yun po, construct D and do the following. Set of ordered pairs such that the range is 1 less than the domain. Kagaya po nito nung ginawa natin dito. Set ating ito, order pairs. Okay? So, po, kagaya lang po nun. So, set of ordered pairs such that the range is 1 less than the domain. So, for example, magbigay tayo na example po dito, class. So, sabihin natin ang ating domain ay ang domain po natin ay 2. Kung ang domain natin ay 2, so ang range natin ay 1. Kasi sabi dito, the domain, the set of ordered pairs that the range is 1 less than the domain. 1 less than the domain. So 2 and 1. So yun po. Adaha. Less than 1 less than the magsusubtract lang po ng isa. So, kung ito ay 3, so therefore, ito ay 2. Kung ito naman ay 4, ito naman ay 3. So, ganun lang po. Ano? Okay? So, yun na po. So, iniiwan ko na po sa inyo yung 2, 3, and 4. Kayo na po bahala mag-interpret ng ating given. Okay? Remember that all functions are relation. Ito yung sinasabi ko kanina. But not all relations are functions. All functions are relations, but not all relations are function. Para isang ang relasyon na hindi siya mag-function. Okay? So, an equation in two variables represent a function if the exponents of variables are positive integral exponents. So, function po ito. Then, this is not a function. Kasi, ang ating exponent dito ay 1/2. Ang ating exponent dito ay negative 2. Okay? Okay, yun. So, that is not an integer. The exponent is not a positive integer. Okay? So, sabi ko kanina, denote function except for x and y to avoid confusion when you say that y is a function of x, you can write it as y is equal to f of x, function of x, or p of x, okay? That is f of x, p of x. Ano? So, the dependent variable is y or f of x and the independent variable is x. This is the domain and this is the range. So, for example, write in a function notation form. So, therefore, that is, sa substitute nyo lang, f of x is equal to 3x plus 6. And that is, we have, so atin lang isusulat siya into slope-intercept form. So, kaya siya magiging y is equal to x plus 1. Diba? Y is equal to x plus 1. So, therefore, g of x is equal to x plus 1. Sinubstitute lang po natin siya. Na? Ngayon, we have, for example, ito, given f of x is equal to 3x plus 6, find f of 2. So, magsasubstitute lang po tayo dyan. F of negative 3. So, okay? So, kung siya ay f of 2, so 3 times 3 is 6, added to 6, that is 12. Okay? So, f of 2 is equal to 12. And then, for example, like this one, kung negative 3 naman po, negative 3 times 3 is equal to negative 9. Added to 3, that is negative 3. Okay, negative 3. F of negative 3 is equal to negative 3. O, sabihin naman natin, for example, bigay pa po tayo ng example, f of, let's say, f of 5 is equal to 3x plus 6. F of 5 is equal to 3x plus 6. Okay. So, therefore, we have f of 5. Ayan, malabo ng ating ano. F of 5 is equal to, po tayo ng ating okay, so f of 5 is equal to 3 times 5 plus 6. Okay. So, sasubstitute lang po natin siya na ha. So, f of 5 is equal to 3 times 5 is 15 plus 6. So, we have f of 5 is equal to 21. Very good. Okay. So, yun po siya na. Nagsasubstitute lang po tayo. Okay. And then, okay, so yun po po yung ano. If the area of the rectangle is a of x, which is equal to 4x squared minus 3x plus 10, find the area if x is equal to 5. So, substitute all again. So, a of 5 is equal to 95 square units. And, take note, the ordered pair is 5, 95. Okay, so yun lang po. And then, sabi ko nga kanina, may vertical line test tayong pwedeng gamitin to determine if the graph is a function. So, point of intersection is only one vertical line so that this is a function. Ito po yung graph natin, circle. So, the point of intersection ay dalawa using vertical line test. So, therefore, this is not a function. And then, ito naman po, the graph is a function. The vertical line intersects the graph at exactly one point. Yun po yung parabola. Pero kung ang parabola nga po natin ay open left to the right and open to the left, so that is not a function. Okay? So, yan. So, by graphing, no, marunong naman tayong mag-graph. So, x and f of x, yung f of x nga po yung value ng y. So, ayan. Okay, so learning task 2, kagaya ng mga na-discuss natin kanina, so, yun po yung ating ordered pairs. Okay. Tell whether if the given set of ordered pairs, tables of values, are ordered or graph is a function or simply relation. Then, identify also the domain and range called yung x and y. Okay. If it is a function, write the equation in function notation form. Susulat muna natin siya mas madali. Isulat muna natin siya in the slope-intercept form. Then yung y, palitan lang natin ng f of x. Nah. Yan. Okay. We are going to construct the tables. Then, ito yung mga hint natin or situation. The range is 2 more than the domain. Ibig sabihin, kung negative 3 to plus 2, so negative 1. Negative 3, negative 1. Okay? So, sagot na kayo doon. Ano lang po. Then, learning task 3. So, yan po. Okay. X. So, ito lang i-rewrite lang natin sa slope-intercept form. Okay, so magbigay nga po tayo ng isang example dyan. Kung paano magre-write into slope-intercept form. So, for example, hindi natin we have 2x plus 5. Gawin natin negative siya. Negative 2y is equal to 0. Sabihin natin ganyan. So therefore, meron tayong negative 2y is equal to negative 2x minus 5. Diba? And then, divide both sides by negative 2. So, makakancel na yung negative 2. So, y is equal to negative 2 divided by negative 2 is 1. So, x. Then, pwede yung 5 over 2. Okay? So, therefore, we have f of x is equal to x plus 5 over 2. So, ganun lang po kasi yung plan na lahat. Okay. And then cross number puzzle. So f of 6, isa substitute niya lang dito. Okay. So 3 digit ang magiging sagot. Across ano, 3 digit. Then 2 going down, 2 digit lang. Okay, so ganun lang siya. Then graph the functions. Maraming naman po tayo mag-graph ng linear equation. Then, find the x and y intercept and the equation of the line. So, madali lang. X intercept, y intercept. Then, what is the equation of the line? X and y intercept. What is the equation of the line? So, that's all for our week 3 and 4. So, you are going to do this for 2 weeks. Naka-assign po sa inyo lahat yan ng 2 weeks. Okay? So, ganun lang po. That is all about relation and function. Okay? So, once again, subscribe and click the notification bell of our TV channel. And don't forget to like our video. Thank you.